in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise God. Let's lift up our hands tonight in the sanctuary and let's bless the Lord. Psalms 134:2 declares, God, we lift our hands. And immediately, God, as we come before you, God, my hand wraps around this mic, but I give it back to you. You said in Psalms 31:15, my times are in your hand. You said in 1 Chronicles 29:12, in your hand is to make great and to give strength unto all. So, Holy Ghost, before we go any further, we present to you this time, this people. Lord God, this moment, every part of it tonight, we give it back to you. Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, do we right now turn this over. So in this service, as we turn it over, you will turn people around. You will turn things around. You will turn our lives inside out and upside down for your glory and for your honor. Make us the blessing that you pour out tonight, Lord God, at your divine disposal. Pour us out, Lord God. Make us that. Hallelujah. Blessing. Thank you, Jesus, to be poured out before you. Hallelujah. It's a sweet offering, Father God, tonight. Holy Ghost, we need you more than we need anything from you. Love you. We need you. You said in Luke 11:13, if ye then being evil know how to give good gifts unto men, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, to them that ask him. So Lord God, before we ask for things, we ask for you. Come on, breath of God from the four winds of heaven. Breathe on the slain, the dead, that they may live again. Ezekiel 37:9 declares. Come on, lift your hands and open your mouth and lift your voice and tell Holy Spirit, tell Holy Ghost, you're welcome in this room tonight. You're welcome. Your person is welcome. Your power is welcome. Your presence is welcome. All your gifts is welcome in this place. Everything you are, Holy Ghost, you are Savior. You are Deliverer. You are Healer. Hallelujah. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. 2 Corinthians 3:17. Holy Ghost, you are freedom. You are liberty. Wherever you are, Lord God, hallelujah, there will be nothing but freedom. Father God, when you're allowed, Holy Ghost, to be Lord. So where the Spirit of Lord is, where the Spirit is made Lord, where the Spirit of Adonai, my Master, my owner, my everything is, there'll be freedom, there'll be liberty. So tonight, Holy Ghost, we allow you to be Lord. This ain't our service. This ain't our anointing. God, we don't come with our agenda. We come with your assignment in mind. We have not the sense of a meeting. We're not trying to figure out how this is going to happen and how that's going to happen and how the end result of this service will be. That's not our job. That's not our ministry. That's not our mission. That's yours, Holy Ghost. And we turn, hallelujah, this service over to you, this people, this time over to you, and the divine results are yours, yours alone, not ours, in the mighty name of Jesus. You said in Isaiah 40:13, who hath directed the Spirit of the Lord or been his counselor, has taught him. Holy Spirit, you're the teacher, not me. You're the preacher, not me. You're the director, not me. So we're not here tonight trying to look for the sense of the meeting. No, we request for the mind of the Spirit. You said in 2 Corinthians 2:16, we have the mind of Christ. The mind that's anointed. So Holy Ghost, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, we lay aside in our mind every theme, every way that we think you should move and how long you should move and what you should do within your move. God, we right now forsake that. We abandon that. For you said in Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. God, it's impossible to trust you with all of our heart as long as we're leaning on our understanding, as long as we're trying to figure you out. So Holy Ghost, we turn it over. Come on, lift your hands and get on your mouth and say, Holy Ghost, I give it to you. I give you this time. I give you my life. Holy Ghost, I give you the past, the present, and the future, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Holy Ghost, we turn it over to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do what you want to do with whom you want to do for as long as you want to do. Holy Ghost, right now in the name of Jesus, we just want you to know it's yours. It's yours. It ain't mine. It's yours. You said in Matthew 6:13, for thine is the kingdom, the glory, and the power forever and ever. Amen. Holy Ghost, it's your power. Holy Ghost, it's your glory. Hallelujah. It's your kingdom. It ain't mine. This ain't my people. This ain't my church. Lord God, it's yours. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, so come, Holy Ghost, and breathe afresh tonight. You said in Psalms 92:10, I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Lord, tonight we've not come expecting the same, the singular, the familiar. We've come expecting fresh. God, you said in Jeremiah 33:3, call unto me, and I will answer you and show you great mighty things you know not of. Holy Ghost, we ain't come expecting something we've already known. We expect that we know not of tonight as we seek and find you. So Holy Ghost, my beloved friend, my best friend on this earth, I welcome you here tonight. I know you're already here, but I just want you to know you're welcome here in the mighty name of Jesus. For Jesus, you said in John 15:5, without me, ye can do nothing. And Lord, without you, I'm determined to not do nothing. I don't want to step if you hadn't stepped. I don't want to go if you hadn't went. So Holy Ghost, we wait on you, and you're worth the wait. You said in Isaiah 40:31, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, they'll mount with wings as an eagle, they'll run and not be weary in their walk, and they will not faint. Lord, if we wait on you, when we walk, we won't faint. Holy Ghost, if we learn to wait on you, we can run and we won't be wore out and weary. If we learn to wait on you, God, we ain't come to flap our wings and try to make church happen, have church. No, Lord God, we come to spread our wings in faith and wait for your wind to move and wait for your wind to blow. Holy Ghost, so worth the wait. You said in Isaiah 28:16, God, those that believe won't make haste. They won't rush you. Holy Ghost, according to Acts 2:2, you are a rushing mighty wind. But Holy Ghost, we will not rush you mighty wind. We won't tell you you got this wrong to do it. We wait on your wind right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, we wait on your moving. We wait on you like David did in 2 Samuel 5:24, up under the juniper tree until he heard the sound of you going, the sound of your spirit moving like wind at the top of the tree. Then he moved and bestirred himself and followed the wind. Hallelujah, God. When he got to the enemy's camp, he found that the enemy had already been annihilated and destroyed. Hallelujah, God. How many fights are we fighting? How many battles are we working and raging and warring in? It ain't our battle, it ain't our fight, because we won't wait on Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, when David waited on you, didn't even have to pull his sword out. When he stepped into the enemy's camp, the enemy had already been destroyed because he waited on the wind. And Lord, when he got to the enemy's camp, the enemy had been defeated and were gone. Yeah, Lord, the enemy was gone with the wind. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So come on, somebody, lift your hands as wings of faith. We can hear it flap. We can try to hear it make something happen. We got one assignment. The same spirit of faith. Holy Ghost, when you come, you will create an atmosphere of faith. It'll be impossible to doubt God. Holy Ghost, when you come, because you are the spirit of faith wherever you are. Faith in God comes alive. Faith in God is made real. Faith in God becomes more of a reality. Hallelujah, than life itself. Holy Ghost, when you charge the very atmosphere and tables of our heart with your presence. We need you, Holy Ghost. Won't you just lift your hands and say, Holy Ghost, we need you. Yes, we do. We need you, precious friend. Hallelujah. You said the yoke's destroyed because of the anointing, Isaiah 10:27. God, it's not destroyed because of my experience. It's not destroyed because of my charisma. It's not destroyed because of who I am. It's destroyed because of your anointing, your power. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. So Holy Spirit, I'd be a dummy. I'd be a crazy madman if I think I had anything to offer apart from you tonight in this house. Hallelujah. So I pray. So I call out to you, Holy Ghost. You said in your word of Matthew 21, In verse 13, my house shall be called a house of prayer. But you made it a den of thieves. God, you charged the people in your day that they were misusing your house, doing everything in your house for praying. So Holy Ghost, before we go anywhere, before we sing one song, before we make an announcement, Holy Ghost, I hope that God churches will learn that again. Oh God, the old school rule, hallelujah, that we seek you first, we pray first, we call on you first. We don't start services with announcements. We don't start services talking about what the church activities next week's going to be. No, Lord God, we start with calling on you, calling out to you. Come, Spirit of God, move by your strength and your power. Stretch forth your mighty hand tonight with the sickle of your strength in these latter times, and reap a harvest for your bride. For you said the Spirit and the bride say, come. Hallelujah, Revelation 22, 17. So Holy Ghost, we know your bride can't say come and see results without you first coming. Before a sinner can come to Christ, Holy Ghost must come to the church. The Holy Ghost must be allowed. You allow the Holy Ghost. You do what you want to do. It ain't my service. It's yours. I've preached without you. Lord, I can count on one hand in 25 years how many times I've done it. I'm addicted to doing it with you. You said with God, hallelujah, all things are possible. With God, nothing shall be possible. And Lord, that's the key with you. When we are agreement with you, when we're alongside of you, working with you, in harmony, letting you lead, Lord, it's then that everything impossible becomes possible. Hallelujah, miracles are manifest. So, Holy Ghost, you're our greatest need, and my God, if we don't hear nothing else, we've already heard, even while we're praying, the heart of God revealed. We need you, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Without you, Holy Ghost, the church ain't nothing but a corpse.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We need your power. Amen. Amen. And somebody shout, amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Welcome back, Marvin Booth. I just left you. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm serious about that. Praise God. I'm back. Praise God. Sometimes I call on him and I forget where I am. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.